coming in at 6.5 or 17 inches, this is Nick Fury from Secret Invasion by Marvel Legends. I look an older figure and one that's beginning to thin out on a lot of clearance shelves, but I picked this up regardless and just had a look at it. Because I think there's some ways we can customize this and improve it, and I'll get to that shortly. So first of all, the packaging. If you've seen the TV show, was not great, but there we go. We got a Skrull logo up at the top. It's part of the Build-A-Figure Hydra Stomper Wave. We got a nice shot of Sam Jackson there, and the digital render of the figure. Secret Invasion down the bottom with the AI-generated stuff that nobody seemed to like. All of the parts there connect to build Hydra Stomper, and as you can see, this is part three, which is the left leg. On the back, you will see he comes with pretty generous two weapons, two pew-pew effects, and two smoke effects, as well as the leg there. So pretty good range of stuff, as well as not a swap-out head as some pictures portrayed, but it's a removable beanie, which has got to be a first for Marvel Legends, I think. That is the UPC for the figure there. Let's get a look at Nick. So, pretty cool overall rendition of him. I think if we zoom in a little bit more, and let's get a look at this beanie first, and let's just remove it, because that's all it is, a removable beanie. Yeah. Looks a lot better without it. So his beard's very shiny, which was way more grey in the show, but very beardy, very bushy, but a pretty nice facial sculpt overall. Let's zoom in just a little bit further. So you get some nice scarring there, some nice details, I should say. If this had been maybe matte sprayed down a little bit, it maybe would have been not quite as ridiculously shiny, but it still looks quite good as a Nick Fury head. Not too shabby. Not too shabby at all. So we got a couple of reused pistols here. As you can see, one there. Pretty plain stuff with a little smoke effect. Or you can attach, if you wish, one of the two differently sized little blast effects instead of the smoke. It is your choice. One's big, one's small. That is pretty much it. Same for the smoke effects. One is a larger wisp there. And one's just a little bit shorter, not much. And this pistol here, this pistol here is, again, we've seen it before, but still looks good. Gunmetal, little silencer piece. I don't think that's separate, is it? No. I thought it was separate from a piece there. No, it's not. So, one huge big jacket that he's got on, but I think we're gonna slice it live and let's see whether we can improve upon that and open up this jacket, because really there's nothing else to show you other than the standard kind of brogues that Marvel Legends always put on kind of suited figures. Not a great deal going on, and there probably won't be a great deal going on underneath, but it really inhibits the figure, the sealed jacket there. So let's see, let's take this apart and see what we can do, and then we'll get a look at the articulation. So let me pull back right there. So we're going to take a box cutter, and I might make a mess of this figure, but I don't care. So I'm just going to first of all slice down gently along the seam. And it would help if you've got a sharper box cutter. I'm using a slightly blunt-ish one here, because the one that I've got that's sharp would literally just slice right through everything. So I'm going to try and take this with a couple of scores, and that way it's taking its time and it's going through the plastic overall, I think, relatively satisfactory. Let's see how this goes. Okay, I'm going to do this in 1 second. Okay, so I did have to use a slightly sharper knife, in fact. This one's way sharper than the box cutter, but the other one had cut just enough in there. So let's zoom in and just see what difference that makes. So you can then see underneath the body, just a relatively plain board, nothing else going on there, just a black polo neck. You could take the arms off. Let's have a look at what it's going to look like with the raincoat off. The Nick Fury trademark raincoat, which is now caught in that arm. It's probably going to look a little silly, but we'll have a look at it anyway. Given it's all in black, it's roughly blending in. Yeah, it's got weird shoulders on it. But what it does show you is you've got a lot more flexibility in the sculpt overall. It's actually not terrible. It's a little weird with the neck going on there. See, it doesn't quite fit, but at least getting that jacket opens up a lot more flexibility into the figure. So let's see what we can do. And he's got a little, is that a little butterfly joint in there? Let's have a look. No, it's just extra big on the shoulders. That's much better. That works a whole lot better. So you can have some movement in the figure. You can have a leg posed out of there, something like that. It just adds a bit of a better dynamic kind of range to the figure to have that jacket opened up a little bit. Doesn't look quite right, but you know what? I don't care. Just a bit of fun having this extra figure here and just the ability to just pose it around. And there we go. We've got a slightly upgraded Nick Fury, just with a little bit more posability. That jacket was just too restrictive, man. Way too restrictive. That's better looking, I think, overall. So in terms of his head and ball joint, you can see up at the top there in the neck, that goes all the way down. So you've got a ridiculously good head sculpt for Nick Fury and reasonably good all the way back. Arms have quite a deep reach as you saw within there, so there's plenty of range and motion around there. You get a single joint, a double joint at the elbows, I should say, which is really deep, really good. And down to, let's focus in a bit better, swivel on the wrists, and you've got an articulation point up and down. As we can see, we have a pretty good, or in fact, not very good, ab crunch up at the top. No waist swivel, which is wow. No waist swivel, good God. Then up at the top of the legs, we've got a pin, thigh swivel, double joints at the knees, and the rocket ankles, the standard legs that have been used many times before, but much better, more dynamically posable Nick Fury, I think, overall. That's a bit more fun to kind of have as an action figure rather than just a statuesque figure there. So, not too shabby. That's it. That's a quick look at Nick Fury, the skull. Sorry, I should say the Secret Invasion, not Skrull, but yeah, pretty basic figure, nothing too exciting, but still with a little modification, you can have a bit more fun with it. But it was what we expected with this wave. None of them were particularly strong, I think, overall, to build this, and I think that's why the wave is perhaps lagged for a lot of people, a lot of fans. But there you go. Even if you want to pick up one or two, you can then build towards the Hydra Stomper. Go have fun. That's it. We'll see you for more videos coming up soon.